My day starts when the plane lands. Once the plane is brought back into the hangar and the data is removed from the plane, that's when I start looking at it to see if there's any problems that we can address prior to the next flight so that we don't waste flight hours and fuel. Ready?
I've got some thermal infrared imagery here. And you can see the hot spot of the lava lake. You can see the lava tubes a little bit through there.
Prior to launching a satellite, or even after launching it, the airborne instrument is used to calibrate that satellite or to develop new algorithms for the satellite that is being proposed. The master instrument is a MODIS Airborne ASTER Simulator. We have four major areas of the electromagnetic spectrum that we look at, from visible to thermal. As the plane's flying straight ahead, the instrument's scanning the ground underneath in a full 360-degree rotation. At 20 kilometers of altitude, we can capture about 37 kilometers of the ground in this airplane. Everything in this world has a spectral signature, and so by combining different wavelengths of light, you can ascertain the presence of a certain compound, element, or aerosol based on their spectral signature. There are different particles in the atmosphere: water vapor, ozone, pollutants, sulfuric acid from the volcanoes, a lot of things in the air column. By getting above the entire air column, you can then predict what the satellite is going to see and make certain assumptions based on that.
Here we have the master instrument, the MODIS Airborne ASTER Simulator. We have a spinning mirror down here that's allowing light to be collected and folded up into the system, where it passes through beam-splitting dichroics, folding mirrors, and it gets passed into different detector arrays within the spectrometer that collects the visible through the thermal infrared. We have to keep the detectors very cold because the shortwave, midwave, and longwave infrared detectors are sensitive to heat.
I really enjoy working for NASA because of all the interesting people that I get to meet and places I get to go. We're on cutting edge technology. There are so many things on the Earth that we still don't understand. We need the data to input into our models to better predict things like weather or extreme events, climate change, for instance, and just basically document our changing world.